Hi all, we'll discuss some basic concepts related to fractions, and these fraction concepts will be helpful to the primary students. Okay, basically what is fraction? Okay, fractions will, you can take on any quantity or any number, you can take fractions. Okay, when fractions will come, when any number is divided into some equal parts, okay, then out of that equal part, some parts will called as a fraction. Okay, fraction always you will denote in this form. Fraction always you will denote in this form, that is x by y, means x can be a number and y can be another number. Okay, but always the condition is that y should not be equal to 0. Okay, because y should not be equal to 0, then only this will be called as a fraction. That is the basic fundamental of a fraction. Okay, and here what we called as x we called as a numerator in fraction. Okay, and y we called as a denominator. Okay, there are various types of fractions. Okay, first we'll discuss about the proper fractions. Proper fractions is one of the type. Okay, we'll discuss about this type. In this proper fraction, always the numerator is less than the denominator. Proper fraction condition is always the numerator should be less than the denominator. That is the condition. Okay, so if, what are the examples? If you take 5 by 6, this is proper fraction, because here what is the numerator? Numerator is 5. 5 is less than 6, so it is satisfying this condition. So it is a proper fraction. And what is the another example? Suppose if I take 9 by 10, this is also proper fraction, because what is 9? 9 is x. Okay, in the fraction 9 is x, that is numerator. What is y? Y is 10, that is denominator. 9 is less than 10, so it is also called proper fraction. Okay, and there is one condition: if you take any proper fraction, this value always less than when, less than 1. This proper fraction value always less than 1. Now we will discuss about the improper fractions. Okay, improper fraction is like, this is fraction. Okay, here this is numerator and this is denominator. In improper fraction, always the numerator is greater than denominator, that is x greater than y. Okay, so in a fraction, if the numerator value greater than the denominator, that's called improper fraction. What are examples? Examples is like 12 by 10, because here what is the numerator? 12. What is the denominator? 10. Here 12 is greater than 10, so this is improper fraction. Okay, another example, 13 by 11. Here also, what is the numerator? 13. What is the denominator? 11. 13 is greater than 11. This is improper fraction. Always the value of improper fraction is greater than 1 or equals to 1. Means the total value of this always greater than 1. Okay, that is in general, any value of the improper fraction is greater than or sometimes equals to 1 or. Now we will discuss about the equivalent fractions. Okay, if some fractions has equal value, then those fractions are called equivalent fractions. Suppose, example, we will take 5 by 10, 6 by 12, 7 by 14 and 8 by 16. Okay, why we are calling this as equivalent fraction? Because these fraction value all are equal, because that is the reason we call it as equivalent fraction. How these are equal? 5 1 is 5, 5 2 is 2. That, what is the value? 1 by 2. Similar way, 6 1 is 6, 6 2 is 12. What is the value? 1 by 2. Here also, 7 1 is 7, 7 2 is 2. What is the value? 1 by 2. Here also, 8 1 is 8, 8 2 is 16. So what is the value? 1 by 2, because all has the equal value. Okay, all these fractions have the equal value. That is the reason we call these fractions as equivalent fractions. Now we will discuss about the mixed fraction. Okay. In mixed fraction, when we call the fraction as a mixed fraction, if a fraction contains integer part plus fraction part, that's called mixed fraction. Okay. What are the simple example for this one? Okay. 1, 5 by 6. Okay. If you see here, why I am calling this fraction as mixed fraction, because 1 is an integer and it contains the fraction also. 1, 5 by 6 is mixed fraction. Similar way, 2, 5 by 6. This is also mixed fraction because it contains the integer 2 and fraction 5 by 6. Another one, 3, 8 by 5. This is also mixed fraction. Why? Because it contains integer 3 along with the fraction 8 by 5. Here in this mixed fraction, this fraction can be either proper fraction or improper fraction. Anything will be valid over here. Now we will discuss about the reciprocal of a fraction. Okay. Reciprocal of a fraction means, okay, there is a fraction that is in the form of x by y. Okay. Here we know that x is numerator and y is denominator. What is the reciprocal of this fraction? That is, if we interchange y to x and x to y, that is, if the both numerator and denominator were exchanged, then that is called reciprocal of a fraction. I will tell one example. There is a fraction 3 by 4. Then what is the reciprocal of this particular fraction? We have to interchange the numerator and denominator. So what is the value here? So 4 should be here, and that is 4 should come upside. That is, denominator will come as numerator and numerator will be changed as denominator. So this is called reciprocal of a fraction. These concepts are basics only, but these basics will be helpful for many competitive exams. Thank you.